Hey guys, thank you guys for tuning in. Today I wanted to talk about Kyrie Irving and the trade rumors that have been going around about him. But before we jump into that, I just want to make sure that you guys like, comment, subscribe. My goal is to get to 600 subscribers by the end of June, and we are 8 subscribers away, and it would mean the world to me if we can hit that 600 mark. So if you want to help a brother out, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe, and leave your thoughts in the comments below, and let's jump into the video. My name's Emmanuel Cammy, and you're watching League Talk. It's almost the end of the season, and it's almost the off season, and rightfully so, we have started to hear about trade talks, trade rumors, and today I wanted to talk about Kyrie Irving and his future, specifically in Brooklyn. The Brooklyn fans are going to crucify me for even entertaining this subject, but you know, who cares? Let's jump into it. So, writer and author Matt Sullivan is reporting that there have been rumors, whispers, and rumblings in the Brooklyn Nets front office about a potential Kyrie Irving trade. Well, that's not what the report said. The actual report was that the general manager of the Brooklyn Nets, Sean Marks, was not happy with Kyrie Irving taking that hiatus mid-season to go party with his sister, and he was not happy about that. And because of that, he's looking and he is open to listening to ideas for a potential Kyrie Irving trade. Here are my thoughts and my take on the whole situation. First of all, if you are a recurrent viewer of this channel, I really appreciate you. But if you are a recurrent viewer of this channel, you would know my stance on Kyrie Irving and where I stand when it comes to Kyrie Irving. I'm not a fan of Kyrie Irving, but let me clarify this up. I'm a fan of Kyrie Irving's game. I'm just not a fan of the guy Kyrie Irving. He's an incredible talent, and his abilities make him very fearful for every team in the league. He is mesmerizing with the basketball and can do things with the basketball that, you know, we haven't seen in a long time. Something he can do things with the basketball that only he can do when it comes to handling and finishing. He's one of the best at that in the league. He's a great piece to a team and certainly makes a team more lethal on the offensive side of the basketball. But with that being said, he is not a crucial piece to this Brooklyn Nets team. He's not a necessity for this Brooklyn Nets team. He's a cherry on top. I've said it in the past before, a healthy Kevin Durant and a healthy James Harden with solid role players is more than good enough to win a championship in today's league. And I'm for the idea of trading and moving off of Kyrie Irving for a few reasons. As I've said in the past before, one of the things that pisses me off about Kyrie Irving the most is how Kyrie carries himself. By carrying himself, I mean doing things that make him become a major distraction for whatever team he plays on. Whether that is neglecting his head coach and saying that him and Kevin Durant don't need to be coached and can coach each other, has an effect on the entire team, and it affects the locker room dynamic. You can't just single yourself out like that and make yourself super special. It may not rub off well with other players, and it may affect the chemistry that you have when a coach is trying to plan things out for you and your specialties and your capabilities. That became a big distraction when he said that, or when he just beefs with the media and refuses to do interviews and gets fined for it just to make headlines. That again becomes a major, major issue and a major distraction for whatever team he's playing for. He did that at the beginning of this season, and that became a big, big talking point, and he was all over the headlines, the news, and it's just not a good look for him. Or finally, the straw that broke the camel's back, when he took that hiatus, that leave from the team, I think he left for like a week to just go party with his sister for her 31st birthday in during a pandemic, especially, you know, when the league had that whole protocol going on, it was very reckless of him. It was very, he got fined for it. He had to sit out a few games for it. So that is the straw that broke Sean Marks' back. He just went off to party, and I made a video about that during the season, and I got criticized for it, and people were saying, oh, it's his sister's birthday party, X, Y, and Z. And I got a lot of pushback for that, but evidently, I wasn't the only one that was mad about that and pissed off with that, because his own general manager was not happy with that and is willing to move off of him because of that, because that made him miss games, and that added to the already staggering amount of games that he had already missed. Which leads me to my next point, missing games. Kyrie Irving has missed a lot of games due to injuries, and that's my next point, injuries. If you have watched Kyrie Irving from the very beginning, you would know and understand that Kyrie is a very, very injury-prone player. Most people forget because he was taken number one overall, but coming out of college, Kyrie played a total of 11 games in college. He was a one and done, but he only got to play 11 games, and he was still taken number one overall, because that goes to show just the talent that he is. But that took away from the fact that Kyrie is a very injury-prone player. College, he plays 11 games, and then in 2015, Kyrie goes out with a injury in the finals in game one, and he subsequently misses the rest of that finals. And then Kyrie goes to Boston. When he went to Boston, he got injured before he left, and then that injury bled all the way into his first year with Brooklyn, and he had to sit out a majority of the first year he was in Brooklyn. And then last year, he missed time due to injury, and he had to miss the bubble. He missed going to the bubble with like injuries and stuff like that. And then this year, he missed a number of games due to injury and then taking time off. And then finally, in a series against Milwaukee, he missed time with an injury and wasn't able to play the rest of the playoffs. And that's just Kyrie in a nutshell. He's a very injury-prone player. He's like Anthony Davis. The two of them, Anthony Davis and Kyrie Irving, you will almost never see them play a full slate of 82 games in a regular season. I'm not a betting man, but I would be willing to bet money that Kyrie Irving and Anthony Davis will miss time off next year due to injury. I'm just making that call right now because that's how predictable it is. It is so predictable that you are not going to get Kyrie Irving in for the whole season. Sometimes you won't get him for the time that it matters, the playoffs. And that's just who he is. It's just in his nature. He was like that in college, and he was like that in Cleveland. He was like that in Boston. He's like that now. And the higher-ups, the guys that are calling the shots in the front office in Brooklyn, have caught on to this. You're not much help sitting on a bench, you know? You're not much help if you are not playing in a regular season or playing in times that matter the most, the playoffs. And so even though he's talented, what good is that talent when you're just warming the bench? Not everything that glitters is gold, and Kyrie Irving is a perfect amalgamation of that saying. At first, when you look at Kyrie Irving, he's mesmerizing. He's able to give you a lot of points during the game, and he brings people to the stands and to watch, but he won't be there the whole season, and he won't be there when it matters the most, and he is a headache. He at first looks good, but then he doesn't. That's the thing with Kyrie Irving, and it's time to move off of him. The Nets, though, are in a very unique position. They already have two superstars in Kevin Durant and James Harden, two of the top five in the league. So they are more than well off, you know, with these two guys. They're able to win a championship without, you know, Kyrie Irving. And Kyrie will have good market value when he's put on the trading block. Even if the Brooklyn Nets take this statement and deny this statement, I think behind closed doors, they are listening to deals on Kyrie Irving, because stuff like this just doesn't come out unless someone wants it out. And someone clearly wanted this information out. And I agree with the Nets that they should move off of Kyrie Irving. You can move off of Kyrie Irving, move his big contract, and get a bunch of role players for him to surround Kevin Durant and James Harden. And with Kevin Durant and James Harden, a solid cast of role players, you were more than good enough to be a contender team. You won't be as top heavy, and you will have a good deep team. Furthermore, the 2022 season may be the cap, the max, that this trio of James Harden, Kyrie Irving, and Kevin Durant could be together, because after that season, all three of them will enter the player option portion of their contract, which will start to pay them more money, making them even more expensive, and you may not even be able to retain them. So moving off of one early might be the solution, and Kyrie is definitely the worst. If you can move off of him early and get role players for him, you may be able to keep James Harden and Kevin Durant in the future and be able to contend for years to come. And you can get a lot for Kyrie Irving on the market. You just have to make sure you do not trade him into your own conference, because I know a team like Philadelphia would want to trade for Kyrie Irving, especially with their situation with Ben Simmons. They will want to get him off your hand, but you cannot trade him into the Eastern Conference. Trade him out West. And those are just my thoughts on the whole Kyrie Irving trade situation. I agree they should move off of Kyrie Irving, because in sports, I always say it's better to move early than late. And I agree they should move off of Kyrie Irving. But those are just my thoughts on the situation. Let me know what you guys think in the comments down below. Do you agree? Do you want Kyrie to stay in Brooklyn? Any take that you have, leave it in the comments down below. And yeah, like I said, if you guys can help get to that 600 mark, that would mean the world to me. And aside from that, make sure to like, comment, subscribe, and see you next time, kids.